they are doing binary operation. Binary operation mean what? Binary mean pair. Operation mean work. That mean it is like the meaning we get work on a pair. Work on a pair. Because this word come from Latin word bis. Latin word bis mean twice or two. And its genitive is binis. So, binary operation in mathematics we define like in general if I take star from Z cross Z into Z mean this star carries the pair of this set AB into Z. That mean if I take star equal to plus, that mean this AB equal to A plus B belong to Z. For example, if I take value of A is 2 and value of B is 3, then the binary operation AB which become 2, 3 produce a new element 2, 3 equal to 5. 2, 3 equal to 5 in Z. Similarly, if I take star equal to minus or subtraction, then this element 2, 3 will 2 minus 3 equal to minus 1 again in Z. That means a pair is carried in Z. And what is this Z cross Z? Z cross Z is we call Cartesian product. Cartesian product. How we define? Suppose if I take two set A which has one and two element, and suppose B is another set which has 1, 3, 5, these elements, then their Cartesian product is A cross B will contain the pair 1, 1, 1, 3, 1, 5, 2, 1, 2, 3, and 2, 5. Like this. This is the Cartesian product which contains the order pair. So this is Cartesian product. Now, binary operation can be other type also. Like, for example, if I define star, like, if I say star on element AB is equal to A square B. That means the star is doing what? Star is doing the square of the first component and the second component as it is added. This is also a type of binary operation. Other also I can define, I can say 2A plus B square. That means the binary operation is doing what? It is doubling the first component and square the second component and their sum. So today our interest is here to define the addition modulo. Now addition means obviously the sum, And modulo mean, like we say, way, or we also can think that, is it a type of method or technique? Or also, this word came from mode. Mode mean also a way. Now, the addition modulo is defined like 4 any two integer, two integers a and b, the addition modulo and denoted by sum of, and in the suffix we put n, where n is a positive integer, is defined as a addition modulo n b is equal to the simple sum of a b and divided by n is equal to r, where r is the remainder. R is the remainder and r lies between 0 to n, 0 and n, and it can be 0. It can be 0. So this is the addition modulo we define, and on the same pattern we can define multiplication modulo n, that is multiplication modulo. Now, why we need this and from where this idea came? This idea actually came from, because we know that in a month, generally we take 30 days. In a month, there are 30 or 31 days, but their names are only seven. That means if on 1st August is Sunday, 1st August is Sunday, then 1 plus 7, because we know that after each 7th day, the Sunday will repeat. That means on 8th, again Sunday. Similarly, on 15th, again Sunday. So, the question we can make here, if on 1st August, 1st August, day is Sunday, then what day fall on 10 August? So similarly, simply we can say that 1 plus 7 on 8 Sunday, then 9 Monday, that means 8 Sunday, 9 Monday, and 10 is Tuesday. 10 is Tuesday. More question we can frame here, like if I say what day on 25th August. So what I do? I see the multiple of 7. 21 is the multiple of 7. That means 1 plus 21, or I can write 1 plus 7 into 3. That means on 24th, again Sunday. Now we have to say, we have to seek our question answer is 25th. That means I add one here, on 25th Monday, on 25th Monday. So this is the idea. Same we can make the same argument we can give with the time, because after each 12 hour the time start repeating. So days are repeating after each 7 day. So this is the idea. Now on this addition modulo, if I ask you the question is G with addition modulo suppose 3. Now its elements are 0, 1, 2. Group. My question is this set a group? This is obviously non-empty set, and our operation is binary operation, is addition modulo 3. Now simply we can do the Kelly table. This is our operation. And our element is 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2. Now, 0 is added. What was the definition? Definition was A modulo 3B is equal to A plus B divided by 3 equal to remainder. We take remainder. So, remainder will be our result. So 0 is added in 0 and divided by 3, we get obviously 0, and 0 plus 1, again this is we take 1 because it is not divisible by 3, so here 1, and similarly 0 plus 2 divided by 3, our remainder is 2 because the number is not divided by 3. So it is 2. Now this is again 1, 1, 1, 2, and this is because the remainder, this we take r must lie like this. So now 1 and 2, 1 plus 2 divided by 3 equal to 0. Similarly, this is 2, 2 plus 1, this is 0, and 2 to 4, this is 2 plus 2 divided by 3 is equal to 4 by 3, our remainder come 1. Now, what we find here? We find here that the outcome is this, and this outcome again is in G. So we can say closure property is satisfied. Number two, associativity. Associativity we can easily check. This also be satisfied. Associativity is obviously satisfied. Number three, identity. What element plays identity? Obviously zero. If zero is added to any element, we get the same element. So identity is zero. Now fourth, inverse. Now what is the inverse of zero? Obviously inverse of zero is zero itself, and inverse of one. Now we locate the zero element, because the element, the definition of inverse is B is inverse of A if, you recall this definition, if A star B is equal to identity, or B star is equal to identity. That means our result, what we add in 1, that we get identity, and identity already we know it is equal to 0. So inverse of 1, see what we add, that means 2 is added with respect to our binary operation is addition modulo 3. So 2, and similarly inverse of 2 is, here is 0, 1. So hence we can say G is group. Hence G is group. G is group. Now, one more thing. Before we do another question, one more thing we do.